We welcome you back, and we're going to debut our big board over there. Our team of insiders standing by live for more on this morning's top story. So let's say we get,
let's get to it.
Okay, first up, how about the criminal probe into the death of the gorilla at the Cincinnati Zoo to determine what circumstances may have led a child to fall into the animal's enclosure in the first place. Dan Abrams, you know him, our chief legal analyst, joins us live. We talked about this a little bit in the first half hour, Dan, and there's a lot of growing outrage against the parents, a mother in particular who was there, and people are saying that they should be criminally charged. Could that happen?
Well, look, under Ohio law, it is a misdemeanor to endanger children. What does that mean? It means that you basically create a substantial risk for the health of a child by failing them in a duty of care. I don't think that's going to happen in this case. First of all, I spoke with the eyewitness, Kim O'Connor, that woman whose video you saw. Mm-hmm. She was standing right there when it happened. I talked to her last night. She said the authorities haven't even talked to her. And when I talked to her, she said she did not think this mother was negligent at all. She said she just turned around for a few moments to deal with her other kids. The next thing she knows, she turns around and her child is in the enclosure.
Oh, wow. It's amazing. She said she doesn't think the mother should be charged at all because there have been a lot of public opinion. This is a massive story. And we have a tweet from our social scroll from Ina who says the mother should be fully charged for negligence of a child. What was she doing at that time? And I'm just curious, being a legal analyst, will the public outcry have any effect on the investigation?
Yeah, well, I don't know how Ina knows exactly what happened at that moment, but I will tell you this. I think it is because of the public outcry that the authorities are saying that they're investigating this at all as a possible crime. I think without it, there would be no quote-unquote investigation at all.
But it has. It's lit up social media and people talking about it. And so we'll see. And they said the investigation is just beginning, so we'll see what happens from here.
We'll see what happens from here. Thank you, Dan. Now, let's get to Kit Harington. Bit of a big story out there. He's best known for his role as Jon Snow on HBO's Game of Thrones. And the actor is now saying men face sexism in Hollywood, too, Robin. Mm-hmm. Yep, Sarah Haynes joins us live. Hey, Sarah, how are you?
Hey, Michael, I'm good. Yeah, we're hearing from Kit Harington in a recent interview. He did address the fact that sexism, it, it